present for Mum. Tick. Firewood. Tick. Christmas tree. To you, it's just another chore on your list. But for the Christmas tree industry, it's a logistical nightmare, with bells on.
Around 80 million real Christmas trees are sold worldwide each year. That's more trees than they have in Yosemite National Park.
It's got to be the right shape, colour, size. Oh, and everyone wants the exact same thing, all in time for Santa Claus. How do they do it? The tradition of decorating a tree for Christmas began in Northern Europe during the 1500s. And today, Christmas trees are big business. Denmark exports over 10 million trees every year, worth nearly $300 million. And the country's leading grower of Christmas tree seedlings is Mylands. They specialise in the Nordman fir tree.
The Nordman fir is so popular because it doesn't shed its needles. And this saves a lot of mess because an average tree has over 200,000.
Growing the perfect Christmas tree takes at least 10 years. And they need to grow them in massive quantities. Each year, over 3 million Nordman firs are planted at this nursery. The growing process can't be hurried. It takes 2 years before they mature into saplings. Now, they're between 8 and 20 centimetres tall. But you'd be hard-pressed to string Christmas tree lights on these little fellas.
Christmas trees used to be decorated with candles, but surprise, surprise, they tended to catch fire. But then in 1882, Thomas Edison's business partner invented the first electric tree lights. It wasn't really until the 1930s, when most people had electricity, that they caught on.
To keep those budding branches bushy, netting holds Jack Frost at bay. It's a giant blankie. One sheet covers up to 6,000 square metres. That's enough to protect 350,000 tender seedlings. The problem is that things soon get crowded. And like teenagers demanding their own rooms, the firs need more space. The solution is for the growers to pull up two-thirds of the two-year-olds and transfer them to a new field. The company enlists this robo-planter to help out. A tractor tugs workers along, who fit the saplings into rotating planters. And the tractor doesn't even need a driver. The reason? GPS keeps everything and everyone in line. When finished, the growing trees will be spaced exactly 6.5 centimetres apart. The saplings are a long way from Christmas trees, but after 4 years in the soil, the budding Yuletiders are ready for graduation. The plant lifter scoops them up, dirt, roots and all, with a flat 1.3 metre wide grate. This gently separates roots from soil with minimal damage. The machine works like a giant colander. A bit of shimmying and shaking filters the dirt and leaves behind the saplings. These trees will now be replanted on farms like this one, in the village of Mousing. They'll spend at least 8 years here. And when they're finally all grown up, the job of bringing them down to earth falls to this guy. A full-throttle, one-man felling machine. 4 trees a minute. 240 trees an hour. The problem now is how to clean up after him. Not to worry, a nifty auto baler saves the day. This machine does it all. First, it gives the trees a tidy trim. Next, a claw snags the trunk, then pulls and wraps it in one fell swoop. Finally, a conveyor piles the trees onto a pallet. sorry, but it's economy class for everyone. In only 40 minutes, it stacks 100 trees.
Not everyone likes real trees, though. In fact, artificial trees have been around since the 1800s. Back then, they didn't have plastic, so they were made from goose feathers that were dyed green and then attached to wire branches.
With the trees neatly packed, they begin their journey across Europe, ready to take centre stage at Christmas in homes from London to Berlin. From seed to sitting room in around a dozen years.